Hello, this is Tatiana Kolovou, and this is Stronger, my LinkedIn newsletter. This is the June edition called Building Strong Health Habits. Nousi yis en somati yi. You may be thinking, that's Greek to me. Well, yes, it is. It's a popular quote in ancient Greece, and it means a healthy mind in a healthy body. Today's times are tough, and many of us may feel physically exhausted while our minds are overtaxed and frazzled. Studies show evidence connecting physical activity and mental health. So in this issue of Stronger, let's focus on tips for building our mental and physical strength. Being mentally fulfilled, alert, and positive allows us to perform at our highest level. A 2009 study published in the journal Depression and Anxiety involved close to 500 subjects, and it showed that 45 minutes of exercise 3 times per week has a significant antidepressant effect. Now, feeling mentally strong doesn't only come from a sweaty power walk. Feeling strong also depends on how we fuel our engines, the type of rest and mental recovery we get, the amount of resistance we put our muscles through, and even the level of hydration in our daily routine. So I'm going to lean on my undergraduate education in exercise science and my American College of Sports Medicine exercise physiologist certification as I share these practical tips with you. Number one, fuel with intention. Your body is your most valuable asset. You should treat it like the most expensive car you'll ever own, hence the fuel metaphor. While I'm not a nutritionist, I do have helpful tips for staying healthy and balanced with your daily fueling plan. High-calorie snacks that enter your home, regardless of who they are purchased for, aka the kid excuse, will get munched on at all hours of the day. So just don't buy them. They should just be avoided. Keep them out of your environment. Instead, cut fruit and make it visible and accessible in the fridge. Pre-cut fresh vegetables or buy them ready to cook. Like fruit, make them visible in the fridge. To prepare for busy days, make meals ahead and divide into portions. And even though it may be less efficient time-wise, try to cook at home as much as possible. Fresh, less processed food means higher nutrition. I'm taking a sip of tea because my throat has been scratchy, as you can hear. Number two, build strength, balance, and flexibility. Now, this is pretty surprising that after the age of 35, we all lose 1 to 2% of our lean body mass each year. Folks, this is no joke. If we don't do resistance training and we sit for hours each day, this is metabolic money in the bank that we lose forever. To maintain strength, consider exercise routines that focus on pushing, pulling, stabilizing, and taxing muscles with the single goal of maintaining lean body mass. Back to the American College of Sports Medicine, I'm a member and a big fan, and also the Centers for Disease Control, they prescribe 2 sessions of strength training each week and 2 to 3 sessions of stretching per week, with the daily routine being the most effective. So for adults over 65, also balance and agility training is a must. Here are ways to fit this in. If your workout routine involves a short bout of cardio, add a song at the end of your playlist and dedicate it strictly to stretching. Find an app. I'm a super fan of Apple Fitness, so if you ask me which one, that's the one I promote. But follow a professional trainer. They've cracked the code to offering 20, 10-minute, or even 5-minute sessions for busy professionals. Now, for the strength-building portion of your day, challenge yourself to any number of push-ups, planks, sit-ups, or pull-ups as physical breaks from your sitting routine. Be sure to start slowly and use resources and sources that are available through the American College of Exercise, for example, versus just following influencers on TikTok. Stand for part of your working day. Standing desks are not only a fad, they mix up your daily routine and keep your core muscles charged up to protect and strengthen your spine. Tip number three, hydrate strategically. Water makes up over 75% of muscle tissue and 25% of fatty tissue, totaling more than half of our body weight. If you're going to be active, and depending on your level of intensity in the outdoor temperatures, keep in mind these guidelines provided again by ACSM, the American College of Sports Medicine. Drink 1 to 2 glasses, 8 to 16 ounces, 2 hours before starting exercise routine. Drink 8 ounces of fluids, preferably not chilled, every 15 minutes during activity. So replenish with 1 glass of water 30 minutes after your workout. If your workout or if you work out in heat exposure at least over 60 minutes, consider mixing up a sports drink into half of your water bottle for added electrolytes. So for everyday hydration, do whatever it takes to keep it at top of mind. Start your day with a full glass of water. I like to squirt some lemon in mine. Keep your water in sight at your desk, in your car, using your favorite reusable water bottle. And finally, keep slices of fruit or cucumber handy or chilled in your fridge. Tip number 4, rest and recover. Short bouts of rest and longer planned recovery are both excellent strategies for being stronger. The benefits of recovery are immense, but in the work world, scheduling a tropical vacation or an amazing hiking trip may not be realistic or even possible. So when things get difficult, have the self-awareness to give yourself a mini respite. Here are some ideas I shared in a previous newsletter on resilience strategies. T-sip. Go outside for some necessary vitamin D and fresh air. Walk, even if you just go 5 minutes out of your door and turn around. It's a 10-minute outing. Arrange for a special meal or find a brand of tea that you enjoy. I'm drinking this turmeric ginger, by the way. Keep plants or flowers in your environment to help liven up your space. Treat yourself to a high-end coffee drink or find a blanket and curl up with a book that reads like a little vacation. Finally, tip number 5. You knew this was coming. Exercise for health versus exercise for fitness are two different scopes. Exercising for health to maintain your current fitness levels and reducing health risk factors, including cholesterol and blood pressure, it's all like 30 minutes per day commitment. The good news is that the guidelines from the CDC and ACSM list the same benefit for short 5 to 10 bouts of exercise as long as you meet the 30-minute daily total. Even better, back to Apple Fitness, you close your rings, as we say. Even better, you only need to reach a moderate intensity level when you can easily talk while exercising. In the big picture of health, every minute counts. Now, exercising for fitness will improve your cardiovascular fitness and help you lose weight. 3 to 5 times a week, 20 to 60 minutes per session. That's kind of the commitment we're talking about. If you haven't been active for a while, your initial goal should be to reach maybe 20 minutes of continuous motion in activities that involve large muscle groups. So examples of those may be brisk walking or jogging or hiking, cycling, dancing, swimming. The common language for fitness instructors is that we say keep it challenging but manageable. You should work so that you sweat enough to need a shower after your session, or you can't just let the clothes dry off. You need to throw them in the wash. There's no way you're going to wear them again. Remember that the key to health and fitness is to develop the habit of moving daily and find ways to keep that up. Here are tips for both of those activities. Number 1, move first thing in the morning before life gets busy. Bring your walking shoes to work or take a 10-minute walk break, or even better, schedule walking meetings, remote ones or in person. Take an after-dinner walk with a friend or a family member. Walk the perimeter of the field while your child is practicing their sport. Park your car further away when you go to run errands. Take the stairs versus waiting for the elevator. I want to know what you do to build healthy habits into your day. Please share some of your ideas with me, and I will incorporate them in my upcoming LinkedIn office hours. So here's something that I'm doing that's an only time. I don't think this has ever happened. I'm having live office hours on Wednesday, June 29th at noon Eastern Time. So what I want to is to get you up and moving, and it's going to be an office hours like no other. So I'm inviting you to a virtual, I'm going to be online, 35-minute multi-cardio workout. This is a workout that can be on any type of fitness equipment in your home studio or your gym, or you can be outside walking, jogging, running. You may not know this, or you may know this. I co-own a fitness studio called Ethos Fitness, Greek name. And during COVID, this type of virtual workout helped us really keep our fitness community together. So LinkedIn friends, this is let's literally run, walk, climb, spin, and row together. Remember to dress for a workout, bring a towel plus your water bottle, and I'm giving you the link of where to sign up. So thank you so much for listening. You can follow me on LinkedIn. I have this in the newsletter, and you can send the stronger version of this newsletter to a friend that you think they may find it helpful. Thank you so much. I'll see you next month.